Chapter 6. Sugar. Of all the foods which it is necessary to conserve, sugar is the easiest to do without. If the war, and what it means, has become part of a person's consciousness, he wishes only the bare essentials. Sugar is a luxury of former times which has become a commonplace today. The average use in the United States was 83 pounds per person last year, 1 2/3 pounds a week. Less than 100 years ago, the yearly consumption was 9 pounds. Sugar was a rare luxury. It will do no harm to regard it so again. Why is there a sugar shortage? Sugar is scarce for two reasons. Much less beet sugar is actually being grown, and some of the cane sugar is too far away to be available. The sugar beet, grown in temperate climates, and the sugar cane, native in tropical and semi-tropical regions, are the only two sources of sugar large enough to be of more than local importance. Before the war, 93% of the entire world crop of beet sugar was grown in Europe. The industry was started by Napoleon in the early 19th century, when he was at war with most of Europe, and France was shut off from her supply of cane sugar in the West Indies. The industry spread over the great plain of Central Europe, from the north of France, over Belgium, Germany, Austria-Hungary, to Central Russia. In 1914, all of these countries were producing enough sugar for their own needs. England produced none at all, but the continent, especially Germany and Austria, supplied her with about 54% of what she needed. The beet sugar industry in the United States started in 1863 and has grown rapidly since 1897. In 1917, it supplied 22% of the consumption. Sugar cane is grown in tropical and semi-tropical countries all over the globe. Cuba leads in the amount produced and consumes only a small fraction of her production herself. Java, too, is a large exporter. India raises millions of tons, but has to import some to fill all her needs. In the United States, Louisiana, Texas, and some parts of Florida produce about 6% of what we use. But our dependencies, Puerto Rico, the Hawaiian Islands, and the Philippines, all export to us, and together with Cuba make up the deficiency. The war has changed entirely the peacetime distribution. The map shows what the battle lines have done to the beet fields of Europe. Belgium and the northern part of France, in which practically all the beets were grown, are in German hands. In 1914, the battle line eliminated 203 of the 213 French sugar factories. In 1916 and 17, the falling back of the Germans had returned 65 factories to the French, but now again some of these have fallen into the enemy's hands. The French crop in 1915 and 16 was only one-fifth of the crop before the war, and the following year it was only a fourth. Italy's crop was 25% less in 1916 and 17 than before the war, and the estimated yield for this year is 50% less. England, of course, can no longer get sugar from the continent. So the Allied world must import cane sugar or have almost no sugar at all. The cane sugar supply is largely dependent on shipping. Ships cannot be spared to go to the east. Therefore, the sugar of Cuba and the rest of the West Indies, our main source of supply, must be shared with the Allies. It is to the credit of all involved that every effort is being made to see that the division is a fair one. A commission representing the Allies, the United States, and Cuba apportioned the 1917-18 Cuban crop and fixed its price. Competitive bidding by the many purchasers, with the danger of forcing up the price of the limited supply, was in this way prevented. The effect of the shortage. The rations of Europe are the most convincing evidence of the extent of the sugar shortage. In England, 1/2 pound a week is allowed for each person, half the average amount used in their households before the war. France had sugar cards long before she had any other ration. 7 ounces a week were allowed, and later in the year only 1/4 of a pound. Germany and Austria-Hungary in 1918 had an average household ration of 6 ounces a week. The United States, in accordance with its usual method, is asking the individual for voluntary conservation of sugar. Each household is asked to observe a voluntary weekly ration of not more than 3/4 of a pound per person. Extra amounts of sugar for home canning may be secured by making a certified declaration to the dealer that it is to be used only for canning and preserving. Food manufacturers using sugar are dealt with more strictly than private individuals. Every business using sugar may purchase it only on certificates obtained from the federal food administrators. At present, manufacturers of essential products, such as canned vegetables and fruits, may get the amount needed to fill their necessary requirements. Manufacturers of less essential products get a percentage of what they used before. At present, soft drink and candy manufacturers get 50%, and ice cream makers 75%. The decreased use of sugar has resulted in the release of the ships which had been used to bring Cuban sugar to this country, 50,000 tons freed to carry men and munitions and food to the Western Front in the spring of 1918. In place of sugar. The United States is much more fortunate than Europe in having sweets other than sugar at its disposal. As our corn crop is immense, the supply of corn syrup is limited only by the ability of the manufacturers to turn it out. It is a wholesome, palatable syrup, and can often take the place of sugar both in cooking and on the table. Although it is not as sweet as ordinary sugar, it serves the body for fuel in the same way. We have cane syrup, and also molasses, and refiner's syrup, byproducts of sugar making, and in some parts of the country, local products, such as honey, maple sugar and syrup, and sorghum syrup. Sweet fruits, both fresh and dried, contain considerable amounts of sugar, some of the dried fruits being over 2/3 sugar, and when added to cereals, for example, take the place of part or all of the sugar. The price of sugar. In spite of the short supply, the Food Administration has kept down the price of sugar by an agreement with the sugar refineries that the wholesale price must not be more than the cost of the raw sugar plus a fixed amount to cover costs of refining. Even during December 1917, when there was a severe shortage in the East, the price remained stable. Refiners say that without regulation by the Food Administration, the price would have gone to 25 cents a pound or higher. At times, the Food Administration has had to use compulsion to keep the price level and has not hesitated to do so where necessary. Licenses have been withdrawn for failure to comply with regulations, and businesses closed for longer or shorter times. One dealer who was charging 14 cents a pound for sugar had his store closed for 2 weeks. Another paid $200 to the Red Cross for overcharging. Another, for selling sugar and flour without regard to regulations, was closed indefinitely. To cut down on sugar. Use fewer sweets of any kind, and use sugar substitutes. Sugar does serve a desirable purpose in making certain of our foods more palatable, but the quantity necessary for this is small, and for much of it other sweets can be used instead. The household consumption uses by far the largest percentage of the sugar supply. Its economical use also helps to provide a reserve for preserving surplus fruits. Such extras as candy and cakes can be entirely dispensed with. Of course, sugar is a food, as it is burned in the body for fuel, but there are two good physiological reasons for avoiding excessive amounts. If we eat a large quantity in candy after already sufficient meals, we are overeating and may suffer from digestive disturbances in consequence. Eating sweets instead of other food is also bad and a cause of undernourishment. Sugar is pure carbohydrate, and although we may eat enough to satisfy the feeling of hunger, the body will lack minerals, protein, and other substances absolutely necessary for its well-being. The person may feel satisfied, but he will be undernourished nevertheless. The conservation of sugar will not only permit a fair distribution to our associates in the war, but ensure a sufficient amount for our own men. It is especially valuable for them because it burns so rapidly in the body that it gives energy more quickly than other foods. End of chapter 6.